Hi there, Doug Stuman with IT Creations with another one of HP's Z-Series workstations, the ZHE5. No, not the Fury, but I did do that one a few weeks back and you can see it here. This one is just the ZHE5. Well, actually not just the Z8, because there really is no just this or just that about this system. That would be like saying a Ferrari is just a car. I'm talking dual fourth generation Intel Xeon scalable processors, up to 1 terabyte of DDR5 memory, plus support for 2 high performance NVIDIA or AMD GPUs. If you like our channel, hit that subscribe button or give us the thumbs up. Let's get to it. This system is good for anything you can throw at it, but HP specifically mentions BIM and 3D CAD, rendering with ray tracing in real time, plus advanced simulations and visualizations, and that's just the architecture, engineers, and construction, or your basic AE and C side. Then there are the creative media and entertainment professionals who need fast video editing, powerful visual effects, sound and color editing. Also, product designers and engineers, data scientists and analytics, and software developers integrating virtual reality into their virtual worlds. Like I said, anything you can throw at it. This system has the same case as the Z8 Fury G5. They're actually kind of hard to distinguish between the two, as there is no Fury printed on the Fury case, so it looks just like the Z8 G5. It's kind of like that Parent Trap movie, where they both look the same, but one has a posh English accent, and the other is from Sonoma wine country or California or something like that. They may look the same, but definitely have their own personalities. Performance-wise, the Fury has the edge with support for up to 4 GPUs with a single processor and more memory. But don't discount the ZHE5 with dual 4th generation Intel Xeon scalable CPUs, up to 1 terabyte of memory, and support for 2 double-wide GPUs. The ZHE5 is perhaps better suited for processor-intensive workloads, but also benefits from a little GPU acceleration. Are you interested in the HP ZHE5 workstation? I know I am. But if you are, then for a limited time, you can save up to $500 off the purchase price of a system that you configure or that's listed on itcreations.com at $5,000 or more. Just click that link for more information. And when you're ready to make a purchase, just mention this video. And you too can decide if you want the posh English version or the laid-back California edition. Forget that last part. On the front of the chassis, there's a handle at the top, a control panel, 2 5.25-inch media bays, and an optional slimline optical device. Only one of the 5.25-inch media bays is configurable from the factory. The control panel offers a power on button, HDD activity LED, combo headphone microphone jack, 4 super speed USB type A 5 gigabit per second ports, with the far left one supporting battery charging. There's also an optional SD card reader. The Fury had 2 options for the control panel with slightly different ports, a standard and a premium version, which offered a few 20 gigabit per second USB Type-C ports. For the media bay, there are options. You can install a single 3.5-inch or 2.5-inch drive in an optional HP DX175 drive cage, which fits into the front 5.25-inch media bay. The drive frame holds a rugged drive carrier, providing additional security with a lock and something that is easily removable for transport or for use as a backup. You can even get a spare carrier for it, too. Another drive cage option supports dual M.2 drives. I'm not sure why the quad M.2 drive cage is not supported on this system, but I don't make the rules. The quad is for the Fury and the Z6 G5, while the dual version is for this platform and the Z4 G5. Both drive options are made in partnership with Crew, and I placed a link in the description down below for more information on media-based storage options. That Crew Ships module kit supports select M.2 drives. On another note, the ships part, you guessed it, another acronym for Secure High Performance Storage. I think they just threw the I in there. It has an active management feature called FANS, an acronym for Front Accessible NVMe Storage. More on that in a bit. On the back of the system, again, you have the handle at the top. A PSU on the left-hand side can either be 1125 watts, 1450 watts, or 1700 watts. All are 90% efficient. The I/O panel offers a power on button, 6 USB super speed type A ports offering 5 gigabit per second data transfer speeds, and 2 integrated RJ45 1 gigabit Ethernet ports. That knockout panel is where you can install 2 more RJ45 10 gigabit Ethernet LAN ports. This system does not have integrated monitor support, so you will need a discrete graphics card to power any monitors you might add. Those graphics cards will also determine how many monitors you can add. If you plan on using older monitors, it is possible you may need an adapter to connect the monitor to your system. You can also add in a Thunderbolt 4.0 card for super fast data transfers. Once we pop open the system, the Z8 G5, like the Z8 Fury, has a very clean layout with brushed aluminum panels covering everything. No doubt these panels offer sound insulation as well to support the whisper quiet acoustics. Yes, this system is very silent. The blue bars inside indicate removable components or something that might secure something else. Like that one for the media bay that you just tilt up a bit to release whatever you might add in there. So don't expect everything to come out. Excessive force is not required on this system. Once you remove the brushed aluminum panels, a cooling shroud covers the CPUs and memory module slots. Fresh air is directed from the front of the chassis to the rear with definite cooling zones. For the memory, inline CPUs and PCI slots at the bottom of the chassis. The towering CPU heatsink features a vapor chamber. In other words, the copper hoses in those aluminum cooling fins have a bit of liquid which circulates at higher temperatures to effectively cool the CPUs. The CPUs are from the gold or silver 4th generation Intel Xeon Scalable series of CPUs. The top rated gold supported on this system, the 6448Y, supports a TDP of up to 225 watts, has 32 cores and 64 virtual threads, plus a base clock frequency of 2.1 GHz and 4.1 GHz max turbo frequency. It also supports memory speeds of up to 4800 MHz. Again, these CPUs do not offer integrated graphics support, and that's where you need the GPU. With both CPUs installed, you can realize up to 64 physical cores and 128 virtual threads. With 8 memory channels per CPU and 16 memory module slots total, you can add one memory module per channel. At capacity, it will support up to 1 TB of memory with all slots loaded with 64 GB registered DDR5 memory modules. As a matter of note, DDR5 memory does provide a 1.6 times increase in performance over DDR4 at only 3200 MHz. Memory speeds are dependent on the CPU and include 4800 MHz, 4400 MHz, and 4000 MHz depending on your choice of CPU. All told, you can install up to 136 TB of storage in this baby. There are 2 PCIe Gen 4x8 slots at the top of the chassis, or personality slots as HP likes to call them. Those can be outfitted with dual M.2 NVMe drives mounted in an HP dual Z Turbo M.2 drive carrier. If you want to use both of those slots, you will need both processors installed. That goes for memory and PCI slots too, both processors installed for full support. Additional storage can be added via the PCI slots using quad or dual M.2 Z Turbo drives. If you do add the dual M.2 NVMe drive carrier in the 5.25 inch media bay, then the NVMe connection for that is just below the personality slots on the system board. If you add in SSDs and want RAID options, a virtual RAID on CPU or VROC key can be installed. VROC will provide RAID options of 0, 1, and 10 with a standard key, or add RAID 5 to the mix with a premium key, and up to RAID 10 with some aftermarket VROC upgrade module. As you can see, there are 4 3.5 inch storage bays in the lower right of the chassis. Depending on how storage evolves over the next few years, that value most likely will not age very well, as they are listing 12 terabyte SATA drives and up to 4 terabytes for the M.2 drives. Using those maximum capacities for drives, the 136 terabytes is achieved using a combination of M.2 and 3.5 inch SATA. Specifically, 2 M.2 drives in the media bay, the 4 internal drive slots with 3.5 inch SATA, the 4 personality M.2 drives, and probably 4 HP quad Z Turbo drives in the PCI slots. That doesn't leave much room for the GPUs, but there are 7 PCI slots featuring a mix of PCI 3.0, 4.0, and 5.0. Considering the options, GPUs in slots 2 and slot 4, which are PCI 4 and 5 respectively, with a x16 length and link width. Setting up Linux operating systems is a different animal from Windows, but there is documentation in the user guide to help you do it. If the lights on the front or back panel start blinking, or if you hear beeps coming from the system, it is definitely telling you something. This is where you start troubleshooting for problems. There is a maintenance and service guide which can help you with that. Also useful is the HP PC hardware diagnostics, of which there are 3 versions. One for Windows, one for the Unified Extensible Firmware Interface, or UEFI, and one, a remote version of the UEFI version. Select models only. HP Sure Recover is built into the hardware and software and can help restore the system without installed Recover software. It's only available on select products. But at the top of the line, I'm going to assume that the HP Z8 G5 is one of those. HP Anywhere is available on a PCI-mounted card or externally mounted device. HP Anywhere provides remote access to the system from a single secure interface. It enables remote support and maintenance from anywhere you have an internet connection. The front crew ships modules also have their very own front accessible NVMe storage or FANS software. Fans is a separate software utility to facilitate rapid ejection and general monitoring of the drives, including internal drives that may be part of a RAID with those mounted in the media bay. For documentation on all of that stuff, visit IT Creations. I put a link below. For this system, we installed two AMD Radeon Pro W6800 GPUs at a power draw of 250 watts each. The Pro W68 GPU is an enthusiast card. I'm going to say enthusiast is not very well defined. However, the performance of this card is measurable and easy to define. High performance! It features a PCIe 4.0 interface, 32 gigabytes of GDDR6 ECC memory, hardware ray tracing, up to 6 high-definition displays, and accelerated software multitasking. Yes, there are 6 mini display ports on the card. These are a few of my favorite things. I always had a hard time getting through that movie. The Pro W6800 used to be AMD's greatest GPU ever, and it still does say that on the site, but I'm gonna assume that that honor is now in the possession of the AMD Radeon Pro W7900 card. That one consumes up to 295 watts peak. I mean, the W7900 is advertised as a professional graphics card. Also has RDNA 3 architecture and 48 gigabytes of GDDR6 memory. Still a PCIe 4.0 interface. RDNA 3 is the next gen answer to RDNA 2 on the W6800 card. The NVIDIA RTX 6000 Ada is also supported on this platform, along with quite a few others from both NVIDIA and AMD. Bluetooth is another option you can install with the Intel AX210 Wi-Fi 6E Plus Bluetooth 5.2 non-V Pro PCI card. There's also a WLAN antenna for hooking up with all of those wireless peripherals. As on the Fury, you can install a low-profile Thunderbolt card featuring a PCI x4 interface. Also a few network cards you can add if you plan to rack mount the system, offering up to 25 gigabit Ethernet. HP's new line of Z-Series workstations are quite impressive to say the least. With the Z8 Fury G5, Z6 G5, and the Z4 G5, not to mention the Z8 G5 I reviewed today, I'm going to say most bases covered. You know, what they are missing from their lineup, at least so far, is a platform powered by an AMD Ryzen Threadripper Pro 7000 WX series processor. I do quite look forward to that. Hopefully it's on the near horizon. If you are looking for this system or perhaps one of those other Z series G5 platforms, maybe an upgrade to an existing system, check out itcreations.com. Just click that link or one in the description below. Chances are we have what you need. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. Until next time, I'm Doug Stuman with IT Creations, and thanks for watching.